Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about buoyancy and Archimedes principle. First of all, let's discuss about, what is buoyancy? Buoyancy. It gives an ability for the objects, to float on fluids. So let's understand, what is meant by, buoyancy. When a body is, partially, or wholly immersed in a liquid, an upward force acts on it. This upward force is called as, upthrust, or buoyant force. The property of liquid to exert an upward force, on a body, immersed in it, is called buoyancy. When a body is, immersed in a liquid, it will experience, the following forces. First, weight of the object acting in the downward direction, due to gravitational pull of Earth. Second, the forces acting on the body laterally, due to lateral pressure. Resultant of all these lateral forces is equal to zero. So the force due to pressure is not considered in calculation of buoyant force. Third, the upward force or buoyant force acting on the body, due to buoyancy. The three types of buoyancy are, positive buoyancy, negative buoyancy, and neutral buoyancy. Positive buoyancy occurs when the weight of the object is less than buoyant force. Neutral buoyancy occurs when the weight of the object is equal to the buoyant force. Negative buoyancy occurs when the weight of the object is greater than the buoyant force. Positive buoyancy. An object floats because the buoyant force is greater than the object's weight. This happens when an object is lighter than the fluid it displaces. Some examples of positive buoyancy are: a swimmer experiences a great amount of buoyant force. Israel's Dead Sea is famous for attracting floating tourists. Salt water is less dense than fresh water and provides more buoyant force. Neutral buoyancy. Due to neutral buoyancy, an object neither sinks nor rises because the buoyant force is equal to its weight. This happens when an object's weight is equal to weight of the fluid it displaces. An example for neutral buoyancy is: a scuba diver is trained in techniques to regulate buoyancy underwater. Swimming horizontally and taking deep, long breaths allow the diver to propel forward, not upward. Negative buoyancy. Due to negative buoyancy, an object sinks because its weight is greater than the buoyant force. This happens when an object is denser than the fluid it displaces. An example for negative buoyancy is: a submarine is designed to operate underwater by storing and releasing water through ballast tanks. If the command is given to descend, the tanks take in water and increase the vessel's density. Characteristics of buoyancy. Let us consider a bowling ball and a balloon filled with air. If we try to immerse them in water, the bowling ball will sink, and the balloon will float. It is because density is ratio of mass and volume. Even though bowling ball and the balloon are having same volume, the mass of bowling ball is larger than the balloon, so density of bowling ball is more than that of the balloon. So the balloon will float. Let us consider a steel ball and a steel bowl made by deforming the same steel ball. If we immerse them in water, the steel bowl will float, while steel ball will sink. It is because steel bowl and steel ball have same mass, but the volume occupied by the steel bowl is more than that of steel ball. So density of steel bowl is less than the steel ball. So, steel bowl will float on water. Now let us derive the expression for buoyance force. Consider a container completely filled with liquid. Let us immerse a box having area of cross section capital A and volume capital V into the liquid. Let F1 be the force acting on the upper part of the box, and F2 be the force acting on the lower part of the box. P1 be the pressure acting on the upper part of the box, and P2 be the pressure acting on the lower part of the box. H1 is the depth of the box from surface of the liquid to the top of the box, and H2 is the depth of the box from surface of the liquid to the bottom of the box. Rho is the density of the liquid. At depth, H1, pressure on the upper surface is, P1, is equal to, H1, into, rho, into, g. Downward thrust, on the upper surface is, F1, which is equal to, pressure into area, which is equal to, H1, into rho, into, g, into, a. Let it be equation number, 1. At depth, H2, pressure on the lower surface is, F2, is equal to, pressure into area, is equal to H2, into, rho, into, G. Upward thrust, on the lower surface is, F2, which is equal to, pressure into area, which is equal to, H2, into rho, into, G, into, A. Let it be equation number, 2. Therefore, resultant force is nothing but, upthrust, or buoyant force. That is, Fb is equal to F2, minus, F1, which is equal to, H2, rho, G, A, minus, H1, rho, G, A, which is equal to, A, into, H2 minus H1, into, rho, G. But, A, into H2 minus H1, is equal to volume, V, where, V, is, volume of the body, immersed in the liquid. Therefore, upthrust, F, B, is equal to, V, rho, G. But, V into rho, is equal to, mass of the object, M. Hence, Fb, is equal to M into G, which is equal to weight of the liquid displaced, by the immersed part of the liquid. The above equation, is the expression for, buoyant force. Now let us discuss about, Archimedes' principle. Archimedes, is a Greek mathematician and inventor, of Syracuse. He is famous for his discovery of Archimedes' principle. Archimedes' principle states that, when a body is completely or partially immersed in a fluid, it experiences an upthrust, which is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by it. Let us understand the Archimedes principle by considering an object floating on the water. The weight of the body is acting in the downward direction due to gravity of Earth. The force due to buoyancy of the liquid, acting in the upward direction, is equal to the weight of liquid displaced by immersed part of the object. So, a body immersed in a fluid experiences a buoyant force, equal to the weight of the fluid it displaces. Let us understand the Archimedes principle through an experiment. Take a solid, and suspend it by a thin thread, from the hook of a spring balance, as shown in figure. It gives some value, note down its weight as, W, gram force. Now, take a Eureka can, and fill it with water, up to its spout. Arrange a measuring cylinder, below the spout of the Eureka can, as shown in figure. Now, immerse the solid gently, into water of the Eureka can. The water displaced by it, gets collected in the measuring cylinder. Note down the weight of solid now, as W1, gram force. Thus, according to Archimedes' principle, upthrust force is equal to, W minus W1, gram force. Thank you for watching this video.